Hey there, welcome to today's video. It is 11:30 p.m. and I was just about to start a very exciting project and decided that I should just film this because part of me thought, you know, this might make a great video. So we'll see where this goes, but welcome to my channel. Today's video, as you can tell by the title, is going to be minimalizing my swimsuit collection. If you've been following my channel for a few years, then you definitely remember my swimsuit collection from 2016, my best bikinis for small boobs videos, and all of the clothing hauls and brands that I've been so thankful enough to work with. That being said, I have a lot of swimsuits. My swimsuit collection video from 2016 is super outdated because this is currently my floor. Fun fact, my floor looks like that because yesterday my boyfriend Tyler and I had a pool day. It was beautiful here in Minnesota, like literally 85 degrees, sunny, not a cloud in the sky type of day. When we stopped at my apartment so I could change into a swimsuit, poor Tyler was waiting for me for like 30 minutes because I went a little crazy and couldn't decide what swimsuit to wear. Not because I didn't have one to wear, but because I just had too many. I started to overthink, like, okay, which swimsuit is going to look the best with tan lines, which one shows a lot of my back and bottom side without being too much, and which ones match my towels and my nails. And I was very overwhelmed by just too many options. I came to the conclusion that the only thing to do was to empty out all of the swimsuits that I own and really just cut down on what swimsuits I own. I don't know if I'm going to be able to donate some. I own a lot of swimsuits that I've never worn before, so hopefully I can donate those. And then I own a lot of swimsuits from like literally when I was 16, almost, what, like 8 years ago, that I just have to throw away. Lately on YouTube, I've watched a lot of like clean with me or declutter my closet or reinventing my wardrobe type of videos or just cleaning out my room because I think it is super motivational to watch other people cleaning and see the process. I just thought it would be like a fun before and after transformation video to make. It's summer, why the heck not? So if you're new to my channel, this isn't like my typical content, but lately I've kind of just tried to make as much content as possible because of some other events going on in my life. If you don't know what I'm talking about, check out my recent videos. Before we get started, please give this video a thumbs up and comment down below as well as subscribe. We really are like one big family with lots of love to go around. It's never too late to join. All you have to do is hit subscribe. Also, don't forget to click the bell because this notifies you every time I upload a new video, and I always shout out the first comment on my social media. So definitely follow me on Instagram and Snapchat as well. Can we talk about my tan? Because I'm pretty proud of it. You should see my backside. Let me try to show you. That's pretty good, right? Also, it's like 92 degrees right now and it's almost midnight, so we have definitely entered like the humid and hot part of summer that most people really don't like. I honestly don't mind it because I love summer and I'd rather be hot than cold. It's just the way that my body works. I do have my fan going. Hopefully that noise isn't too obvious. My windows are also open and I'm just having like a really great wholesome summer night. Let me show you the process as to how I am deciding to declutter my swimsuit collection. This bin is where I keep all my swimsuits, and the first thing that I did was just I dumped every single swimsuit that I own out onto the floor. And the only swimsuits that I put back and kind of folded is my one and only one piece swimsuit. I used to be a camp counselor and I'd have to wear one piece when I swam with the kids. So this is why I own that, for any situation that might cause me to need a one piece. And then this old swimsuit that actually used to be my mother's from the 90s when she was my age. Oh, did you bring me a toy, Marnie? Okay, I've got it. I've got it. Here, girl, go get it. My mom had me at 21 and I was born in 1995, so she was definitely like young and thriving in the 90s, and this is one of the swimsuits that she owned. And then somewhere in my teenhood I took the swimsuit, and now I just save it for sentimental reasons because it was my mother's back in her prime. But with all that being said, I have a lot of swimsuits to minimize on, and currently my cats are just having a ball. Literally. I'll try to keep them distracted. I think the method that I'm going to go with first is I just need to put all of my top and bottom pieces together and lay them out fully, like top and bottom together on my bedroom floor, so I can get a visual image of how many like full sets of bikinis I own, and then we'll go from there. Swimsuit organizing montage starting now.
just not high profile.
I just finished laying out every single swimsuit that I own with its pair. This is the aftermath. Marnie, really, come on. But we have all of these. And then these are all the swimsuits that I bought in pieces or have been given in pieces. So now that I have all the swimsuits that I've ever owned all over my bedroom floor, the next step is to go through them one by one and try to figure out like the last time I wore them, try them on, how well they fit me, and kind of like Marie Kondo this and create a donation and just get rid of pile. I'm just gonna go through my swimsuits one by one, starting over here, going down each row and then deciding whether or not to keep them. I think if it's not an automatic keep, I'm going to try them on and then figure out how I feel in them, kind of like the Marie Kondo style of cleaning out your closet and see how confident and good I feel like in my skin in the swimsuit. And then we'll get down to the mix and match pieces that I own on my bed and figure out what to do with those. The first swimsuit that I matched over here is one of my favorites, and it's just like this marble set. It fits my body type really well. I got this for LA a few years ago. This summer I'm really into thin straps because it allows for better tan lines, and this has a very simple like crossbody X in the back. So this is an automatic keep, and I'm gonna put this in my swimsuit basket. The next swimsuit is technically a mix and match. I love the floral pattern on the top. I think it's very innocent and girly. And again, with the simple straps that allow for great tan lines. So automatic, yes, I'm keeping you because I wear you every summer and I feel good in that. The next swimsuit that I have is a more recent purchase, or I guess gift, from Blooming Jelly. I did a brand deal video with them and they sent me this very, very cute, kind of like sailor styled pink striped swimsuit. I really, really love it. I love bottoms that have the hip lines like this. I also think it's a little bit more appropriate if I'm with family and whatnot because it's not as exposed as some of my other swimsuits. You don't really get a good tan out of it, which kind of sucks, but if I'm ever swimming inside or if it's cloudy and I'm not worried about that, I guess this will be okay. So this is a keep as well. This next swimsuit was also in the same video with that brand. I recently got this. I've never actually really worn this swimsuit, but I did like the top. I featured it in my best bikinis for small boobs video, so if you wanna know why I like it and see me in this bikini, you can watch the video above or down below. But I've never worn the bottoms, and I actually did not like the bottoms because they're a very, very funky shape, and they just did not fit my body type. Like, whose butt is like this big, honestly? It was just really, really weird. I could try to donate you because I've never worn you, but I'm definitely not keeping you. I'll just put you over here for now. That being said, now you are a mixed match gingham top, which might be hard to match. If I do not own any white bottoms or anything that matches this, I will get rid of this suit as well, so I'm gonna leave it out on the floor for now. This next suit is super, super cute. I got it from Zoffle. I believe it was part of a brand deal as well a few years ago. It's also like a triangle top, which surprisingly worked pretty well for my body type. I'm definitely going to keep this because it's something that I still want to wear today, and for a triangle bikini, it fits my body type really well, and I can get some really good tan lines out of this. I also wore this to Tessa's place a few summers ago when I went to visit her, so this always reminds me of that pool day with Tessa. I miss you, Tessa. Hope you're watching. So this is a keep for the men's. This next swimsuit, I've actually never, ever, ever worn the bottoms. Like, throwback to 2014 when the style was totally in, like, this weird lace mesh material. It's super cute, but I think this is one that I'm going to have to try on to really decide whether or not I'm going to keep it. So I'll leave it on the floor, and I'll try on all the swimsuits that I'm unsure of in the next segment of this video. This swimsuit means a lot to me because it was my very first bikini ever, and it's actually super sad to think that, you know, I think it served its purpose, and the time has come to move on. I haven't worn this swimsuit in a few years, but back in its glory days, this was the only swimsuit that I ever wore. I thought it was the cutest thing. I think it still is. I wore it so much that these bottoms are actually in really disgusting shape now. I wore it so much that little dots of mold started to appear. This happens if you have a damp or wet swimsuit that doesn't dry properly and the water just becomes really moldy. A sign of a very, very loved swimsuit for sure, but also a sign that I don't really want to wear this swimsuit out anymore just because it's so loved that it's just not in the best condition. So unfortunately, I'm gonna be throwing away these yellow bottoms. I love you, thank you for your purpose and the memories and everything you've done for me, but goodbye. I'm going to leave these out for now because I think it's still super cute and fits my body type, and I'm not sure what to do with it, so hopefully I have some bottoms that will match this. I'll leave it on the floor for now and we'll get back to that. The next swimsuit is also a more recent favorite of mine. I got this from Zoffle last year from Myrtle Beach in LA. I don't think I've ever worn it yet, which makes me sad. Like, I don't feel like this has served its purpose yet, so I'm gonna keep it because it's cute and I know that its time to shine will come. down to row two. I love this orange swimsuit so much. It's not even a question. Like, I've wore it to Myrtle Beach, to Chicago, to LA, and it has never failed me. I also love how it's the only swimsuit that I have that's just like a straight line across, and it fits my body type, and I think I look really good in orange. So that is definitely a keep. This next swimsuit is super sentimental to me too, because way back when I was 14 or 15, this was a tankini from Macy's, and I secretly cut the tankini and made it into a bikini. Surprisingly, it still looks really good. I honestly forgot that I owned this swimsuit because the basket where I keep my bikinis was so full I couldn't even find it, which makes me sad and was another reason why I knew I had to do this and just declutter my swimsuit. But it's too sentimental and still in great shape and not like thick at all. Like, it's just a simple strap tie bikini. It even has those holes on the side of the hips that I like for tan lines. So this is definitely a keep. It also reminds me of high school because that's when I used to wear this, so it makes me feel young. This next swimsuit is another favorite of mine. I got this from Target. It was one of my first bikinis. The top doesn't have any straps, so it really depends on your body type, but this one fits my body type so well. This is the swimsuit that I ended up wearing to the beach with Tyler yesterday, and I felt good. I felt confident in it, and I love neon because I think it really brings out your tan. Also, I have really fun tan lines on my chest right now, like that little dark triangle. Yeah, so this is just like a must. Like, there's no question about it. That's a keep. Likewise for this blue swimsuit, I got this from Zoffel, wore it in Myrtle Beach last year. It has been a favorite. I actually wore this to the pool with Bennett the other day. If you watch my morning routine, or it might be called like a morning or a day in the life, summer morning routine, whatever the title becomes, this is the swimsuit that I wore. It's from Zoffel. I think it is such a cute baby blue. Kind of feels like mesh or like a mermaid's tail. Yeah, simple. I love it. Follow me on Instagram and you'll see a million pics of the swimsuits. This is a keep as well. Next, the pineapple bikini. This was also part of a brand deal with Blooming Jelly that I recently posted a few months ago. I have yet to wear this out, but it is again a simple triangle swimsuit, which I love tanning in. That being said, I have yet to wear this in public. I will keep this for now because I will wear it. I think it's super cute, and I even have an Instagram caption picked out for that if I ever do get a good photo in it. My favorite itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow bikini. Holy crap, this baby has just like done so much good for me in my life. I wore this to Myrtle Beach and I got a ton of amazing photos in this. If you follow me on Instagram, you've definitely seen the swimsuit. It is by far the highest, like, waisted, tiniest bottoms that I own. I'm obsessed with the shape of this, as well as the cool tan lines that you get on your back from the straps. No doubt about it, definitely keeping this one. Like, I wish I could wear this all the time, and I love that it's ribbed too. Oh my god. Wish I could wear this all the time. Unfortunately, like, some places it just doesn't really seem appropriate to wear because this is a pretty small swimsuit. Number one swimsuit in my life right now, definitely keeping. Next, we have this really fun pink pattern swimsuit that I got from Zoffel. I can't remember if I bought this or if it was part of a brand deal. I've never worn this swimsuit in public. I actually have no idea how I feel in it, so I will definitely be trying this on. This swimsuit is from Victoria's Secret. I really like this swimsuit. I've never really worn it in public. I think I wore it once to tan. It is kind of like chunkier on the front, so this would be another good one for like family outings or if I just want something that's a little more covered. And these are one of the pink bottoms that I kind of mix and match with. I'm going to keep this swimsuit as a more like modest option, but I don't think it's one that I'll be wearing very often. And because I spent a little bit of money on it, I can't part with it yet. We're getting there. We are down to the third row. This blue swimsuit is super cute. I also wore this in Myrtle Beach. I remember that I felt really good in it, and I got a decent tan line because the back of it is just these like three straight lines. So no doubt about it, I will be keeping this swimsuit. I don't know why I didn't just wear this the other day to the pool, because it's super cute and I love it. So that is a keep. Wow, already like it is so much more spacious in here. Okay, this next swimsuit is another old one that I've had since high school. I have always loved this top because it's so simple and the center design is very beautiful, but I haven't worn you in a few years, so I think I need to try you on tonight just to really decide how I feel about you and if I need to keep you or not. Same with this swimsuit. I got this from Zoffel. Again, cannot remember if I purchased it or if it was for a brand deal. I think it was for a brand deal. I love the roses and the flowers on the bottoms, but I've never worn it. In fact, the lining is still on it. I've never worn this top, so I definitely need to try this on tonight to see if there is a possibility that I will ever even wear it. Ho-ho, next we have my scandalous swimsuit. Literally, this is like a thong. The lining doesn't even fit. As you can tell, I have never worn it, but I think it's really beautiful, and it's definitely something where if I ever find myself in Las Vegas or Miami, I'll have to wear it, but how realistic is that? I'm not sure, so I'll leave you on the floor as undecided for now. This is a really old top that I own, again, since like like 2014 or 15. This used to be my go-to swimsuit that I would wear to the lake. I love the neon on the side of the hips. This is from Target, but I haven't worn you in a few summers, so I'm not really sure how I feel about you now. I'll have to try you on as well. And this next top is actually from Zoffel. It's some very, very complicated crisscross that I've never worn. I couldn't even figure it out for the try-on haul. So I think it's just a sign that I have to get rid of you because there's just no way I would ever want to mess with it. It's just too complicated. I almost forgot about the mix and matches on my bed. So this pile, I just have three triangle tops that a friend from high school gave me. She didn't have bottoms to give me, which is totally fine because they're all basic colors. We have this top from Target that I would always pair with these really ugly bottoms, but I actually hate these bottoms. They're so simple. There's nothing on the hips and they're pretty big in the butt. Like they cover your entire ass, which isn't really what I'm going for anymore at 24. But you know, at 17, I'm glad I was wearing something that's covered. That being said, I haven't worn these bottoms since 2013 and I don't think I ever will. Definitely getting rid of these. Next we have these like built-in cupped tops that I almost never wear. And then this is what I wore on my 18th birthday. It's super, super padded and my boobs definitely like dipped out of here. I will never ever wear you, so I'm definitely getting rid of you. Probably you because I've never really worn you, but I also want to try you on to see how you fit. So I'm going to put that in my try on pile. Here is my donate pile and I'm just tossing you. I have this cute floral bandeau top. I have four miscellaneous bottoms that I don't own tops for. Two of these are from my friend Hadley. I really like them and they're pretty cheeky, which I'm always down for. I have this red and blue bottom from Target just in case I ever was on a boat for the 4th, which so far proved never, because I was going to pair it with this, and this is like my patriotic swimsuit, I guess. I think I'm gonna try you on just to get a feel, and if I don't really feel good in you, I'm getting rid of you. I also have some more mesh bottoms that I bought from Target. It makes me sad to know that I literally spent $9 on these, and I never even wore them. Of course, when I saw the clearance tag and saw how cheap it was, I couldn't resist and had to buy it, but that was like 4, maybe 5 years ago, and I never wore these, which makes me sad, but I think I know that I have to get rid of them because I just never wore them, but they're new because they have the tag on, so I know I can donate them. I really like these black bottoms because they're super simple and they match almost anything. So I'm definitely keeping these black bottoms so that I have something to pair with all these triangle tops that I have. And I think this pair of bottoms that Hadley also gave me go good with the green and the blue triangle pieces. So I'm gonna keep these for tanning in them and the fact that friends gave them to me and I have worn them before and they work. These are keepers. That being said, I still have this really fun top that I've owned from high school. I featured this in my best bikini for small boobs video because it is a really good bikini for small boobs, but now I don't own any bottoms for it, and if I don't have bottoms then I probably won't wear this, so I think I have to get rid of these as well. These were from my friend Madison when her boobs grew and mine never grew into them. I thought maybe they would work. They're cupped. I'll try them on tonight, but if I don't really feel confident in them, I guess I will have to give them to another home, someone that could actually fill them. Which leads me to my last swimsuit top, which is the strapless little floral one. I think it's super cute, and again, if I don't want tan lines, I think I'll wear them. I also have bottoms that I know match these, so I think I'm going to keep this top for now. So we completed the first two steps of laying everything out on the ground, organizing them, and then going through and figuring out which ones to keep and get rid of right away. On to phase three, which is trying on the remaining swimsuits to decide whether or not to keep them. Let's get changing. Marnie, no, you are not the star of the show tonight. God, don't mind my PJ shorts. The first top that I tried on is this orange gingham one. I wasn't expecting to like it again as much as I do with it on, but I really like it and I do have those black bottoms. Now that it's on me, I'm gonna have to keep it. Next, I tried on the yellow swimsuit that I've owned since I was like 16. Instantly, I am reminded of like days on the boat and I just feel more youthful and nostalgic about it. I definitely have to keep this as well. I know I was trying to declutter, but so far I'm keeping most of them. Next we have on that top that I wasn't really sure if I could fill. I guess I do fill it, but I don't really feel like good in this top. Like I don't really feel sexy. I don't feel my age. I feel very like adolescent in middle school, like I'm still waiting for my boobs to come in. So I don't really think I'm going to keep it, although it is a super, super cute top. I just know that the time has come for me to give it away. Immediately when I put on this top, I didn't like the way it felt. I didn't like the way that it like wrapped around my body. It was just a no the second that I put it on. It dips in the front, so I could literally flash anyone that I like lean over by. And the straps over here just like hit like my armpit at a weird angle, and it kind of hurts. And I don't really think I'd get nice tan lines from this suit. So this top is definitely going as well. Good news and bad news about the swimsuit, because I've never worn it before. Good news is I love the bottoms. I think they fit my body type really well. Unfortunately though, I remember why I've never worn the swimsuit, and that is because I don't fill out the front enough. Literally one wrong move and one of my nipples is gonna pop. So I think I'm going to have to part with the top for sure. I will donate. The bottoms are fun and funky, and I have those triangle tops that I think will match, so I want to keep the bottoms as a fun option, but I have to get rid of the top. This swimsuit brings back good high school memories too. Again, the top feels great. Like, I've always loved it. The bottoms I really like just because it is a set and I think it looks good together, but they are old, so I feel like I should just toss them and then keep the top, because I would probably still wear it to tan in my backyard with like cheekier bottoms, if that makes sense. So I think it is definitely time to move on, although I really like it now. I'm kind of leaning towards getting rid of it just because I want to declutter and minimize my collection. I'm gonna have to get rid of it. If you remember, this is the really, really old mesh styled Target swimsuit that I got probably in high school as well. The top kind of makes me feel juvenile. I don't know if it's this strap though, so I'm gonna try it without the strap and see if that makes a difference. Okay, I do actually really like the swimsuit now. I'm like falling in love with old swimsuits all over again that I haven't worn in years. Probably gonna keep this. Actually, no, I really hate the top. If I hate the top, should I get rid of the bottoms? I think I have to, right? Wow, I just changed my mind faster than any Gemini ever, so I'm gonna get rid of it, I think. Next, we have my like emergency 4th of July patriotic, just in case I need it, swimsuit. And I'm so glad I tried this on, because first of all, I do not feel confident at all in this top. And I'm glad that I tried it on, because these bottoms are actually breaking. And so because the string over here is broken, I can't even show you, but like the back is gaping. So I can't even wear this because my entire behind is like gaping through. I look like a plumber right now. So I'm gonna throw these bottoms away. It's sad that I spent money on them because I never even wore them. And then I'm gonna donate these, I think, because I never really wear it. I don't know. Can you donate swimsuits? So this one is definitely a bust. I'm surprised I held on to the swimsuit for so long because I feel so not good in it. It's cute if it's your style, and I must have thought it was cute too last year when I bought it, but I've never worn it, and I really hate how the front shows the white seam. Like, there's no way to hide it. The bottoms are so small on me, so I'm just gonna donate this entire swimsuit because I still have the lining on for the bottoms and I've never worn it, so hopefully I can donate it unless somebody wants it. Maybe. Should I turn this into a giveaway? I'll hold on to it. Comment down below if you want this. I guess, should we just do it a giveaway, I guess? If anyone wants the swimsuit, why not, right? Like, it's cute. It's a size small. It's pretty small. So maybe for some of my younger audiences, if anyone wants the swimsuit, just let me know down below and I'll send it to you. First one that wants it, I guess, will get it. Just make sure that you're following me on Instagram and that you're subscribed and all that. We'll make it into a little giveaway. But it's brand new if you want it, so comment down below. Again, this swimsuit is something that I would have loved to wear a few summers ago. In fact, it was definitely my go-to swimsuit, but I feel like I outgrew the style once more because the top, I know I'll never choose to wear. It's super cute and it actually fits my body type really well. Again, just feel very juvenile and it's not cheeky at all. Like, it covers everything, which kind of feels like a diaper to me when I wear, just because it's like so covered. Just my preference. Nothing against you if you like that. It's old. I've worn these bottoms for years. I'm gonna just get rid of them, and I'll hold on to this if I can find a pair of bottoms that would match, because I do really like the top, but the bottoms gotta go. Last but not least, we have this dark purple swimsuit. It has like braided. I really cannot show you guys the back of this because it is so cheeky. I've never worn it before, but just the potential that I know I probably could someday, and that it's by far the most revealing swimsuit that I own, I am going to keep it. It's a little after 1 a.m. I'm officially in an oversized t-shirt that I'm gonna be wearing to bed tonight. And this is the pile of the swimsuits that I am getting rid of, donating, or just throwing away. And here is what's left of the swimsuits that I am keeping. It's crazy to me how full this basket still is when I feel like I got rid of so much, but it blows my mind that this used to be even fuller. I feel like I'm gonna have to do a second round and see if I can get rid of more swimsuits in here that are just old and dated. Like, looking at this, I already want to get rid of this because there's no way that I would wear this. That was easy. Overall, this entire experience cleansing my swimsuit collection felt super, super therapeutic and just good to do. Like I said, when I was trying on the swimsuits though, I did want to make this a giveaway if you are are interested, because some of these swimsuits are brand new and I just have never worn them. They still have the tags or the lining in them. If you are interested in any of the swimsuits that I decided not to keep, please comment down below. I'm gonna turn this into a little giveaway, so just make sure that you're following me on Instagram and subscribe to my YouTube channel and comment down below. I'm just gonna do it based off of like whoever comments first that they want it, you can have it. I know that I said I would give this cute swimsuit to one of my subscribers. If you are interested, it is brand new. It has the lining in it. Comment down below. I also have like these brand new bottoms with the tags on it. If anyone wants this pink pattern top, it is brand new. I've never worn it. You just might have to have bigger boobs than me because I did not fill them out. If anyone wants this set from Target, I've never worn it, so it's in really good condition. Comment down below. It's yours. These are brand new and I honestly don't know who would want them, so I'm just gonna donate them or toss them. These are all the pieces that I'm saying goodbye to. This is what I'm holding on to. Well, thanks for going on this cleaning journey with me at like midnight. This is such a typical thing of me to decide to do this at the middle of the night when I should be asleep. Why not make it into a video? Thank you so much to anyone that watched all the way through. I appreciate you. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your night, and I hope that this encouraged you to go through your closet or your swimsuits and get rid of any pairs that you haven't worn in a few years and maybe try on some pieces and see how you feel in them. But I am definitely just going to go to bed now. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up so that I know. As always, subscribe and comment down below if you want those swimsuits. But with all that being said, I'm gonna go to bed because it's so late. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your night. Thanks again so much for watching. I'll see you in my next video very soon. Bye!